Underpinning is a method of construction that has allowed Cross River Rail to build in some challenging areas.
Underpinning means a transfer of load from one structure to another.
Passenger access tunnels to the new underground Roman Street station and the southern portal structure that enters the twin tunnels needed to pass right below the existing pieces of infrastructure, and Underpinning has been the solution.
It was important to keep the station open, keep the IMB flowing, and just not disrupt our travelling public. And that was sort of the premise of what we've worked together on going forward.
To keep overground busway and train lines operating during construction, Underpinning allows the load of the structures to be redistributed safely. Through a complex mix of engineering techniques, innovative solutions have been developed that reinforce the structures for the overground busway and train lines, enable the team to tunnel safely below.
Construction involved the construction of the micropiles. We then installed a series of footings on top of the micropiles. We then propped the entire bridge off those new foundations that allowed us to facilitate a cut to the existing bridge piers and then install a brand new structural steel collar arrangement around those columns.
While at the southern portal, the main train line needs to connect up to the Bogger Road station, which had to be excavated through the existing pier foundations of the rail freight flyover.
This line's used for freight, coal, all those sorts of things, to be able to go over the suburban lines and travel straight to the port without holding up suburban trains.
Because the tunnel alignment is within the bridge footings, we are required to demolish these footings as we excavate through, and therefore to do that we are transferring the live and dead loads of the bridge itself onto a new underpinning beam.
What it's going to allow is the subcontractor to finish the last bit of the tunnel and be able to mine in and get to Bogger Road Station without having to affect the freight flyover at all.
Because the freight flyover footings are removed, the design response to that was to build these two twin beam concrete structures. We set hydraulic jacks, fixed them on top of those beams to lift the weight of the bridge up. We then grouted those beams to the existing structure and lowered those jacks for it to sit on. Once we let the jacks go, the weight of the whole bridge support structure now sits on the new underpinning structure. As part of these jacking works, we're required to disconnect the old footings from the new structure. In order to do that, we use a wire cutting saw. The wire cutting saw cuts out about a 200mm piece, which is the biscuit. This is grabbed and pulled out once cut, and then that space is then grouted up and remains separate.
For Queensland Rail, we're not going to see much of a difference. We're still operating on that freight flyover. It's just supported by a different structural element.
Now that the freight flyover is completed, that's facilitated us to be able to dig from the dive structure all the way through to Bogo South.
Through collaboration between Cross River Rail's construction team, engineers and asset operators, Underpinning has provided the answer to this complex engineering challenge. Underground stations and tunnels can continue to be constructed while the important assets above operated as usual.